Hello everyone, this is Anuj Sethi and welcome back to another video by AMS Group of Institutes. Now today's video is part of a series called Accounting for Shares. So if you guys are new, then please hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon so that you will get a notification whenever we come up with another video. Now today's topic is share forfeiture. What is forfeiture of shares and how do you account for it? We will see in today's video. So, today we will see how to account for share forfeiture when the company is using the call in arrears account. Now, before we go to the accounting, let's do a quick recap. What is share forfeiture? Share forfeiture is the cancellation of those shares for which the shareholders have not paid the amount. That is, the defaulting shareholders have not paid the amount for these shares, we will confiscate their shares. So, the accounts involved in this are the share capital account, the unpaid calls account, and the share forfeiture account. So, as we have already seen, there are two methods: when the company is not using the call in arrears account and when the company is using the call in arrears account. We have discussed the first method in the previous video. For all those people who have missed it, kindly go to the channel and check out the video. We will today discuss the second method, in which the company is using the call in arrears account. So let's move forward with an example. AMS Limited has issued 1 lakh shares of rupees 10 each. Then we have been given the installments. These were the application 3 rupees, allotment 2 rupees, first call 3 rupees, and the second and final call 2 rupees. We also have some extra information. Mr. A, having 10,000 shares, failed to pay the first and second final call. Hence, his shares were forfeited after the final call. So, firstly, let's underline the important information. He did not pay the first and second and final call. Plus, his shares were forfeited after the final call. So, let's move forward with the question. But before we move to the accounting, there is one step which I always tell my students to follow. That is, mark all those places where there is an adjustment. In our case, there are adjustments in the first call and the second and final call. I'm using a hashtag. You can use whatever mark you want. Make sure it is a distinct mark. So let's move forward with the journal entries. Firstly, we will pass the journal entry for receiving the applications. The entry will be bank account debit to share application. The amount will be 1 lakh shares into 3 rupees. So that is 3 lakh rupees. Bank account debited by 3 lakhs and the share application credited again by 3 lakh rupees. Next, we will move forward towards the capitalization of this entry. Now, since we are not rejecting any shares and there is no pro rata allotment, we will fully capitalize the application money, that is 3 lakh rupees. The entry will be share application account debit to share capital. Amount is 3 lakh rupees. So 3 lakh application debited and 3 lakh share capital credited. Next, we will move towards the next installment, that is share allotment. Now in the share allotment, a trend starts. That is, firstly, we will capitalize the entries and next we will do the payment entries. So let's capitalize the share allotment. The entry will be share allotment account debit to share capital and the amount will be 1 lakh shares into 2 rupees, that is 2 lakh rupees. So share allotment debited by 2 lakh rupees and the share capital credited by again 2 lakh rupees. Now since there is no default in the allotment, we will receive the full amount, that is 2 lakh rupees. So bank account debit to share allotment 2 lakhs. Bank debited by 2 lakh rupees and share allotment credited by 2 lakh rupees. Now we'll move forward with the first call. Now before we do so, I would like to take a caution because there is a default in the first call and we are using the call in arrears account. So firstly, we will capitalize the first call. The entry will be first call account debit to share capital and the amount will be 1 lakh shares multiplied by 3 rupees, that is 3 lakh rupees. So first call debited by 3 lakh rupees and the share capital credited by 3 lakh rupees. Next, we will have the payment entry for the first call. Now in this, we are using the call in arrears account. Now how to calculate the default amount we have seen in our previous videos. So all those people who have missed that video, kindly go to the channel and check out the video. So let's see what will be the call in arrears amount. It will be the number of shares held 10,000 multiplied by the call amount, which is 3 rupees. So the call in arrears is 30,000 rupees. So call in arrears debited by 30,000. Now since we are using the call in arrears account, we will credit the full first call amount. First call was debited by 3 lakh rupees. So we will credit the first call by 3 lakh rupees. So first call credited by 3 lakh rupees. There will be nothing over here. And we will receive only the balance amount in a bank account. That is 2,70,000 rupees. So bank debited by the balance 2,70,000. Let's move forward with the second and final call. Firstly, we will capitalize, but again, we will take a caution because there is a default in this call as well. The entry will be firstly for the capitalization, that is second and final call account debit to share capital. The amount will be 1 lakh shares multiplied by 2 rupees, that is 2 lakhs. So second call debited by 2 lakh rupees and the share capital credited by 2 lakh rupees. Now let's move forward with the payment entry. But a word of caution, there is a default in this. So firstly, we will calculate the call in arrears amount. How will we do that? The number of shares being defaulted, that is 10,000 multiplied by the call amount, which is 2 rupees. So the amount will be 20,000 rupees. Call in arrears debited by 20,000. So next we will go for the second call. Now since we are using the call in arrears, we will credit the full amount which we have debited in the second call. The second call was debited by 2 lakh rupees. So we will credit it again by 2 lakh rupees. So 2 lakhs credited. And we will receive only the balance amount in a bank account, that is 1,80,000 rupees. So bank account debited by 1,80,000. Now we have already seen how to pass the journal entry for forfeiture of shares. The entry is share capital account debit to all the unpaid calls to the balancing figure, that is the share forfeiture amount. Now in this case, we are using the call in arrears account. So instead of writing the names of the defaulting calls, that is the first call and the second and final call, we will use only one account, that is the call in arrears account. So in this case, the journal entry will be share capital account debit to call in arrears account credit to the balancing figure, that is the share forfeiture account. So let's move forward with the calculations for the amounts. So let's make a working note. How many shares are we confiscating? We are confiscating 10,000 shares. So 10,000. Now we have already underlined that we are confiscating these shares after the second and final call. Now since it is after the final call, that means we have capitalized the full nominal value or the face value of these shares, which was 10 rupees. Now since they have been capitalized, so whenever we are confiscating or reversing these shares, share capital will be reversed by the full 10 rupees. So share capital will be reversed by the full 10 rupees. Now how many shares are we confiscating? 10,000. So we will multiply the number of shares and then we will get the amount which has to be debited in the share capital account, which is rupees 1 lakh. Now the next was the call in arrears amount. Now in this case, we do not have to calculate it. We simply have to add the call in arrears which have been debited in the first call and the second and final call. So let's see what was the amounts. Firstly, we'll go to the first call. The call in arrears is debited by 30,000 rupees. And in the second and final call, it was debited by 20,000 rupees. So the total is 50,000 rupees. So there we go. We have our amounts. So let's move forward with the journal entry. Share capital account debited 1 lakh rupees. We have already calculated this. The call in arrears we have also calculated is 50,000 rupees. So 50,000 credited, and the balance amount will go to the share forfeiture, which is 50,000 rupees. 50,000 credited in share forfeiture. So this is how you will account for share forfeiture in case the company is using the call in arrears account. So this is it for today's video. If you found this video to be useful, then please give it a thumbs up and share this link with the fellow peers and students. If you want us to make another video on any other topic, then please use the comment section below. We have also started online classes for commerce, science and MBA subjects. So all those people who are interested can contact us by emailing us at amsgroupofinstitutes@gmail.com. There are no spaces. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to the channel. And as always, happy learning. Yeah.